Oh. You ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure.
Why the hell not?
So, St. John, where did you serve? Before the ship went down. Now you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? I mean, first year out here, it seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, part of SAC.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days. Hold up. I want to show you something.
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah. I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell. You know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, we stopped by here on our honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chivalrous what?
No, it means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
So, where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
What would my mom say if she knew I was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker?
I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear a sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon, I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, well, okay, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there, that's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
Oh, yeah, I bet. So, he knows this is way past my bedroom, right?
Oh, I know.
I wouldn't stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, well, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project. I mean, we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know what? Like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah. No problem.
Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that. Pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah. I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, Deacon, what? Okay, I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on, keep following the trail. We're almost there.
You think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
That moonlight, it's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies. I see you hitting again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay. First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it, and we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah? Deacon?
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So is that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're gonna ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one... The second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you spread your biker ring on my finger?
You know what? I think I probably did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like clenching onto the chain. No, nothing says true love like...
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me like a real ring, though, right? Not that this one's not
absolutely,
great.
Because
I just thought
that's my ring.
Right, it's your ring. Right. Something more simple, without fangs.
Okay.
All right. Oh, shit, I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab. I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello? Yeah. No, it's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick. Let's go.
I got a use for you.
Not unusual, you know.
I'm sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. The phones went away.
I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie. Her father was a photographer. Old school. Dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated him. Cell phones, I mean. It seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
You guys are taking this shit seriously.
Colonel believes with enough motivation and discipline, we can achieve anything.
Come on, hurry your ass up!
I'm going as fast as I can!
Just move it!
Is that your idea of motivation?
Colonel has set up a work camp on the south side of the island for those unfit to serve. Some of them require extra encouragement.
I'll bet.
Come on, follow me.
Yes, sir.
Stand up there with the others. Good luck, St. John.
Got your ass too, huh? Whatever.
Hey, man. It's good to see you again. St. John, right? Son of a preacher man?
Taylor, what's this son of a preacher man shit you keep saying?
I'm just kidding with you, man. Hey, do you have any luck?
What?
The woman you were looking for, you and your peeps were riding with.
No.
I need all your jewelry, watches, shit like that. Come on, in the bag.
Sure, man, whatever you say.
The hell you say?
Recruits aren't allowed personal effects. The side shit's just gonna get stolen. Come on, cough it up.
Yeah, shit's gonna get stolen.
Goddamn bullshit.
Ten hot!
Thank you.
At ease. Visitors are not welcome here. You are here because you were invited, recruited by my trusted officers. When you answer me, start by giving me your name, last name first.
Getting by, same as everybody.
Name.
Atkins, Crystal, sir.
How many men have you killed?
Before or after?
Answer the question.
Fuck you.
We have all done things that we're not proud of.
What?
To survive, to stay alive. The Almighty understands this.
Right.
The Almighty forgives
this.
But here, upon this woman's face, are the footprints of Satan. Prison tattoos. Proof of what you once were and no doubt still are. It's people like her that are responsible for bringing the wrath of the Almighty down upon us all.
Yeah, that's right.
Take her to the work camp.
What?
You.
Get her out of here. Fuck
you
all.
Come on, gorgeous. Let's
go. Goddamn redneck asshole. Get off of me.
Swear to God.
What about you?
Taylor. Wait. And, no, sir. I never been to jail. Never killed anyone, nothing like that.
You've been in the shit for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, I know how to shoot stuff. My dad took me hunting when I was a kid. He was at a camp near Klamath Falls.
And how about you, son? You know how to use a gun?
St. John, Deacon. Yeah, I know how to use a gun.
You're a drifter. Hold out your right arm. 10th Mountain, Iraq?
Afghanistan.
Honorable service, and don't lie to me. I'll know.
Served one tour, served with honor, hated every goddamn minute of it.
Thou shalt not lie. Good man. Hold up your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to support and defend the new Constitution of these United States? Against all enemies, natural and unnatural, to bear witness and support to the same, and to obey all orders without question. So, do you swear?
I swear.
Dismissed! Walk with me, son.
Captain Curry doesn't bring me many recruits these days. You must think highly of your combat skills.
I've been in the shit a long time.
You know your way around the freaks?
Yes, sir. I know as much as anyone, sir.
Good, good. In here. We'll have the doc take a look at you.
Pulse is strong. Good heart rate. Got a pretty nasty burn there. How'd that happen?
Had a run-in with a wood stove.
Wood stove, huh? Who dressed this?
I did.
No está mal. Not bad at all.
Thank you.
Keep it dressed, or you're gonna lose that arm. You hear me, amigo?
Yeah, I hear you.
I want you to check back with me in a few days.
Got it.
Well, Doc.
He's fit to serve. Lo hará bien. You doing runs out in the shit?
Sorry, Doc. Ya tiene novia. He's spoken for.
Let me guess. The Wizard Island Witch. Vaya con Dios. Good luck, amigo.
Let's go, son.
I normally don't tolerate insubordination, referring to an officer as a witch. But I make exceptions for some of my more eccentric officers.
Yes, sir.
I make exceptions because every man and woman still living has a role to play. Do you believe in God, St. John?
Never gave it much thought, sir.
Well, it's high time that you did. He has a plan for us, all of us. And my part is this.
Sir?
This place. I had a vision. Oh, nothing so grand as those described in the Old Testament. No flaming chariots or burning bushes. I simply woke up one morning before God's plague had rained down upon the world and knew that this was the place.
Crater Lake? Wizard Island?
I call it the Ark. Are you familiar with the story?
Yeah, I mean, yes, sir. I mean, everyone's heard of it.
Indeed. You'd be surprised how few have read the Bible or the Book of Revelations.
You mean Genesis, Noah's story. I mean, that... It's the Book of Genesis, sir.
Yes, of course. Okay, son, let's get you squared away.
Whatever you say.
Now, we don't have much in the way of uniforms, I'm sorry to say, but I think that... here. Try this on.
Seems to fit.
I'll take that.
Well, if you don't mind, this is a gift from an old friend.
An old friend? Not many of those left anymore, are there?
No, there are not.
Okay, soldier. But I don't want to see you wearing it. You're one of us now. And normally we start new recruits in the rank of private. But since Captain Curry has vouched for your experience in the field, we are starting you out at the rank of corporal. Congratulations, son.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let's get you some work.
All right. Now, what was I saying?
You were telling me about the Ark, sir.
Yes, the Ark. What you see here is only a small part of it. Behind us is a whole network of caves and vents that lead from here up to the Cone's Peak. When our work is complete, they will be filled with thousands of seeds, plants, computer files, and books. The world may die, but our achievements in medicine, science, and technology will not die with it.
No, sir.
But the island is more than just an ark, Corporal. It is a stronghold, a fortress. Here at the North Gate, we are stockpiling enough munitions to take the fight to the freaks. We have rifles, grenades, heavy machine guns, and RPGs. We have the equipment to make ammunition, every type, every caliber. This is our mechanical engineering area. If you need your bike repaired, see the officer on duty. And as you can see here, courtesy of the old National Guard, we are building a fleet of trucks and other vehicles. Once the hordes are cleared from the highways, we will begin to rebuild the roads and bridges.
Your slash-and-burn strategy may stop newts and swarmers, but it won't clear the highway. It won't stop the hordes, sir.
We are aware, Corporal. The hordes. The hordes are a different beast entirely, aren't they? But we have a plan.
Plan, sir?
Benjamin Franklin once said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. We are not going to fail.
The heart of the army lives here, at the gate, ready to move on my command. These tents house hundreds of women and men, just like yourself, who have pledged and sworn their lives to the fight. But I have something else in mind for you, an assignment that requires more than just the ability to survive in the shit or use a gun. Are you up for it, son?
Yes, sir. Wherever you need me.
You asked how we were going to defeat the horde. Let me show you.
Don't get in my way.
Whoa! Now! Shit!
You okay, Lieutenant?
Oh. Hey, Colonel. Sorry about that. Too much acetone in that batch.
Lieutenant Weaver is our chemical engineer. He's working on new ways
to blow shit up.
Defeat the enemy.
Sorry. But, yeah. Name's Weaver. James.
St. John, Deacon.
All this militia shit's just for show. Right, Colonel?
Corporal St. John is new to Corey's unit. If you need anything from out in the shit, he's your man.
Oh, shit, yeah. Yeah, there's a couple of things I need.
What are you working on?
Oh, just the new gelling agent combining that fennec and palmitic acid.
You working on napalm?
Yeah. Yeah. This dude knows his shit.
Just a lucky guess.
Sorry to interrupt.
Oh, anytime. Oh, Colonel. I'm getting real close, Colonel. Very close.
That's good. That's really good.
Where you going next, Colonel? The Wizard Island Witch?
That'll be all, Lieutenant.
Again, let me apologize for my more eccentric officers.
No need, sir.
We have one final stop. As much as I believe in Lieutenant Weaver's work, what you're about to see could be, I think, our path to victory. In here.
All right, what is this?
Ma'am? I got everything on the requisition form.
Does this look like fabric softener?
No, ma'am.
Okay, why don't you read it?
Active ingredients. Chloroform and a terpene.
Get out.
Shit.
Get out! Matt, I can't do this if I have to do my own supply runs.
I got it covered. Lieutenant Whitaker, this is Corporal St. John. He's a new member of Corey's unit. He's got some experience out on the shit.
Read this.
What?
Read this. I mean, you can read, can't you?
Active ingredients, chloroform, aterpenol, benzo alcohol, ethyl acetate.
Good enough. When can he start?
I'll leave you to it. Carry on, Lieutenant.
Leave us.
Sarah.
Stand at attention. Dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Hey.
You're dead.
It's okay.
You're dead.
I'm right here.
Wait a second. I don't understand. I couldn't find you.
You had died, and I.
No, we were overrun.
And
we had to go south. Nero, they said
Nero,
that no one made it out.
Ryan and
Farewell was overrun. They said that everybody was
mountain.
Dead.
And I didn't think that
I never thought I would see you again.
See.
No.
Hey, Hey, listen, when we can ride out of here, we'll pick a direction, we won't look back. Come on.
No, no, Deacon! I can't.
Are they forcing you to stay here?
No, you don't understand. We're fighting a war. Don't you see? This is a war that we can win.
I didn't come here to fight a war.
I can be helpful. I can make a difference, but I can't go with you. I have to stay here. Don't you get it? You can stay here with me. Help me. Look, afterwards, whatever you say, we can go wherever you want.
Colonel's looking for you.
Whatever you say, ma'am.
Wait a second. Your requisition form. Thank you, soldier.
Corporal St. John to Lieutenant Weaver. Come back. St. John to HQ.
This is Weaver. What can I do for you, Corporal?
Your requisition form says you need mercury. Any idea where I can get it?
Yeah, sure. I should have written that shit down for you. It comes from, Cinnabar. Corey's unit scouted out of mine north of Diamond Lake. Head there, radio me when you arrive.
Yes, sir.
Hey, between you and me? If the Colonel isn't around, stop with all the yes sir, no sir bullshit, all right? Makes me feel old.
Corporal St. John, is it?
Yes, sir.
Come in. Just enjoying a cup of tea, herbal, courtesy of Lieutenant Whitaker. Would you like to try some? It's very good for the digestion.
No, sir. Thank you, sir. I was just looking for the duty roster.
I have an assignment for you. Men, Corporal. Not that they deserve to be called that. They've taken one of ours. Lieutenant Justine Norwood. Fine, officer.
And they have her, so, yes, I will get her back, sir.
With the help of men like you, we're going to take back this world. Dismissed.
Corporal.
Hey, you. I haven't seen you around here before. Name's Jacob D'Angelo. Everybody calls me D.
St. John, Deacon. So, are you the guy to come to for hardware?
You got it, pal. You need guns? I got guns. If I don't have it, it was never made, you know what I mean?
Great. I'll keep that in mind.
Hey, you want it? I got it. Oh, big spender. Cheap in buying a new one, right? Come on, am I right? Huh? Ah, okay. Hey, Corporal. I'll see you.
How's it going, Sal?
Same as yesterday, same as tomorrow, if I had to guess.
I don't think I ever asked, but how did you end up out here?
No, you never asked. And I never said.
Hey, sorry.
So, no? Corporal, you be well.
Move along, buddy, move along.
Corporal, new guy? Name's Caleb. Caleb Tomlinson.
Deacon St. John. Yeah, I just rode in.
Oh, cool, man. Hey, listen, if you need something for your ride, you come see me. Between us, Lucas, the Canuck over at Diamond Lake, he'll rip you off, man.
Great, well, keep that in mind.
Corporal?
Come in. I've got another job for you. Come to the Diamond Lake outpost.
Copy that, Captain. St. John out.
Howdy there, Corporal. What's up?
New around here? Name's Ava Bergstrom. Friends call me Bergie.
Deacon St. John. Yeah, I just got here.
Well, Deacon St. John. You do your job, and we'll get along just fine. How's that?
Yes, ma'am.
Corporal.
Corporal.
Sergeant, so, where are you from, Lucas? Was it? I can't place your accent.
That obvious. From Canada, originally. Yeah, I was down here on holiday with the family. Yeah, doing a bit of camping out, you know, west of Crater Lake. A wife and kids. My boys would have been 8 and 9 this year.
Canada, huh? You're a long way from home.
Ah, tell me about it. Yeah, I was a teacher, engine repair in Calgary at the Technical Institute. Oh, you ever been? No, I guess not. Anyways, the colonel, he gave me this job, so now this is home, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, then. I got parts if you're looking. Well, there you go. Oh, Corporal St. John, you stay safe, yeah? Corporal, what can I get for you?
Hey, Sarge.
Corporal, good. I have a job that requires your unique skills.
Sure. Yeah. Yes, sir.
You remember Vasquez?
The man that went AWOL. Yeah, we tracked him to the logging camp. I remember.
Well, this man, Sergeant Lee Anderson, was his partner. He was about to be arrested when he killed a guard and took off.
Oh, your men have quite the code of honor.
Our men? You're one of us now, remember? I've marked the location on where he was last seen on your map. Apparently, like Vasquez, he wasn't alone.
Great.
Corporal St. John.
Sarge.
Hold on, I got this.
St. John, Corporal St. John. You got your ears on, man? Hey, this thing didn't work?
Yeah, your radio works. What's up?
Deacon St. John, hey. Nothing. This is just... checking in on you. I haven't seen you since the whole swearing in thing. That was some shit, am I right?
Taylor, you know, I'm kind of busy.
What? Hey, what the hell they got you doing? I'm in the damn infantry or some shit. Spend all day burning out nests, chopping down trees, hauling wood. Sorry, what are you doing?
Research. They got me going out into the shit. Lieutenant Weaver, you there? I'm at the mine.
Good. Okay, man. You take a look around. The report I saw listed ore testing kits. You're gonna need one.
Ore testing kit. Copy that.
Cinnabar is kind of red, but not shiny. It'll have a dull luster to it. Gonna be hard to miss. Test the ore. It's gotta be at least 60% pure, or I can't use it.
All right, got it.
Testing kit. Where the hell am I gonna find an ore testing kit? Maybe one of these, shacks? Nothing in here. Fuel can. I need a testing kit. I don't need fuel. Here we go. Ore testing kit. Yeah. What did he say? Red rock, dull luster. Cinnabar. Yeah. Okay, let's test you out. Come on. Yeah, you'll do.
Yeah.
Good night, Bounty. Here it is.
That's the last of them. Let's see if this pump is working.
Jenny's out of gas. Jenny's always out of gas. More cinnabar. That's good. Good. Testing. Yes, you'll work. Not enough. I need more ore.
That's it.
Water's going down. Gotta finish collecting this ore, and then I gotta get the hell out of here. Yeah. Come on, Orr. Let's see how pure you are. All right. Yeah, almost enough. Yeah. And now I just gotta test. Okay, good. One or two more samples is all I need. Cinnabar. Yeah. Nice. This'll work. Alright, let's see how pure this is. Just one more. Just pure enough. Okay, let's test you out. Elevator shaft. Oh, God damn it. Wonder where this goes. Only one way to find out. What's up here? Another tunnel? Looks like this one was abandoned a long time ago. A Nero beacon in here? Another Nero micro recruiter. No.
Jesus, that's
a
big guy. Yes. Yes, it is.
Another Nero injector.
2072. We're at Site 69. The... Where are we?
The Lost Cabin Mine.
Thank you. The Lost Cabin Mine. We have euthanized a specimen of Homo sapiens mutans corporosus using 10,000 milligrams of ketamine. Reference field note 2071. Where 6,000 milligrams was barely enough to subdue the Homo sapiens mutans albino. We tracked the subject from its primary habitat and structures on the northern rim of Crater Lake.
Can I help you, Lieutenant?
What used to be the visitor
center. I ran out of isopropyl alcohol. Do you have
this
any?
Mine. Currently, we have no working theory as to the subject's migratory habits, living patterns, or...
How about why it's so goddamn big?
Don't be such a stranger.
Fuck off.
Yeah, as a matter of fact,
St. John.
Really?
Yeah, yeah, sorry about that. Blood anyway, yeah, just drop off the car as soon as you can. I got some more shit I need you to get.
Extremely elevated amounts of anabolic steroids.
Wait, so what? Before they became infected, they were roided out?
Basically, yeah. Not that they were all bodybuilders or athletes taking illegal synthetic androgens. Some probably had naturally high levels. The result's the same.
Yeah? What's that?
They can literally tear you in half. Come on. Let's get these samples crated up and get out of here.
Oh, roided out freaks. That's just great.
Corporal, need something?
So, man, I gotta tell you something.
Okay.
I knew you from before. Well, not personally, you know, but I'm from Farewell. Same as you. And me and my friends, we used to watch you guys around town. The mongrels, I mean. Riding those hogs, wearing your leathers. Man, we thought you guys were so badass.
Right. Is that right?
Yeah, yeah, man. Had a lot of free time on my hands. I had to drop out of high school, you know. Knocked up my girlfriend, had to get a job. Hey, if you ever decide to, you know, start up an MC, Mongrels, whatever, just count me in, okay? I'm down.
Yeah, don't hold your breath.
Sure, man. Yeah, no, just saying.
Corporal, see ya.
Corporal?
Sarge, how's it going?
Corporal?
Sergeant.
Nice haul. Okay. Corporal, take care.
Lieutenant. Nah, man. Leave that shit by the door. No. I mean all that army shit.
Yeah. Okay. I think that's what you were looking for.
All right. Yeah. Yeah, this is great. Hey, let's wait a second. Here.
Polystyrene.
Yeah, you know, like white foam coffee cups, packing peanuts, shit like that.
Yeah, got it.
Hey, man. By the way, how did it go with the Wizard Island Witch?
You mean Lieutenant Whitaker?
Man, I thought you were gonna leave all that shit by the door. That'll be all, Corporal. That'll be all.
St. John, Corporal St. John. You got your ears on, man? Hey, is this thing even work?
Yeah, your radio works. What's up?
Deacon St. John, hey. Nothing. This is just checking in on you. I haven't seen you since the whole swearing in thing. That was some shit.
Taylor, you know, I'm kind of busy.
What the hell they got you doing? I'm in the damn infantry or some shit. Spend all day burning out nests, chopping down trees, hauling wood. Sorry, what are you doing?
Research. They got me going out into the shit, finding supplies for the officers, whatnot.
Oh shit! Oh, I heard about that. Yeah, working on bioweapons, chemical weapons, shit like that. Burn them freaks around, am I right?
Yeah, look, Taylor, I gotta go.
All right, hey, look, man, it's just, I'm having second thoughts about all this military shit, you know.
Taylor, what radio are you on? Are you sure that you're not being monitored?
Oh, shit!
Huh, that's what I thought. Gotta go. St. John out.
Yeah, always.
Corporal Deacon St. John. Hey, you got your ears on, man? Hey.
Taylor, what do you need?
There you are. Okay. So I finally figured out how to use this damn thing. Alright, I got a secure channel and everything. So how's it going, man?
Taylor, I'm kind of busy right now, so...
Yeah. Sorry, man. Sorry. hey, so word's out in the camp that drugs are making their way in right under the colonel's nose. It's good stuff, too. But do you know anything about that?
I don't do drugs, Taylor, so no, I don't know anything about it. Why?
No, I don't either. I saw this guy, you know, one of the new recruits, acting all suspicious. He runs in and out of camp all the time, and so I thought I'd follow him, right? Let's see what the hell he's about.
Taylor, listen to me. You just go to Corey, let him handle it. Got that?
Yeah. This is a good call, yeah. Okay, Mr. St. John, I'll talk to you later. Out.
Captain Corey, I'm at the site where Sergeant Anderson was last seen.
All right, Anderson, let's go take care of business.
I never knew that.
Yeah.
Which way?
Oh shit, wolves.
This'll help. This is it. How the hell am I gonna get my bounty?
Find another way into that cave. Dead coyote lava cave. Well, nothing bad can happen. Near the beacon. Okay, where is it? Gotta get into that cave somehow.
Corporal Deacon St. John. Hey, you got your ears on, man? Hey.
Taylor, what do you need?
There you are. Okay. So I finally figured out how to use this damn thing. Alright, I got a secure channel and everything. So how's it going, man?
Taylor, I'm kind of busy right now, so...
Yeah. Sorry, man. Sorry. Hey, so... Turns out the camp. Trucks are making their way in. Right under the colonel's nose. It's good stuff, too. But do you know anything about that?
I don't do drugs, Taylor, so no, I don't know anything about it. Why?
No, I don't either. I saw this guy, you know, one of the new recruits acting all suspicious, right? And out of camp all the time, and so I thought I'd follow him, right? Let's see what the hell he's about.
Taylor, listen to me. You just go to Corey and let him handle it. Got that?
Yeah.
I've been meaning to ask one of you guys.
Call. Yeah. Okay, guys. Mr. St. John, I'll talk to you later.
How'd the virus, you know, jump?
You mean, how did it jump, sweetie chief?
Yeah. I mean, you see the cats, dogs, birds, these wolves. I didn't think it was possible.
Do you know what viral zoonotic neuroinvasive disease is, Corporal?
No.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free.
Just like the hooligan virus.
It has come to my attention
spreads through contact
that some of you are out there working with Nero.
semen.
The very same
gross.
Nero.
And
we
while
saw cut down a group of survivors
mammals,
not too long ago.
Lab cultures have shown that it can
the same Nero
birds,
that abandoned us here in this shit
insects.
2 years past.
Do you know how many mammals there
some
are in the world?
Would call these people
lot,
fools.
I'm guessing.
But
yes.
I got a better name for them.
A lot.
Traitors. And I assure you that I don't have the treason lightly.
All of which has his rabid powers of resistance plans.
So you get one warning.
Can be infected and
listen up.
The virus.
Stop what
What's
you're doing.
Do? For us,
now.
Look at the muscular
before we find
subject.
You. Because we will.
A distended
and when we do,
the
you
and radial
will
sites,
pay.
The run 31 to 37 miles per hour.
The biggest tree I find.
This guy,
and while you're breathing your last,
and he can chew the tire off a motorcycle while doing it.
And feed you to the freaks you love.
What it means for us,
that is a process.
Glad that most
this
mammals
is more for radio freedom.
Than us.
Believe the lies.
Let's get out of here.
Yeah, well.
Corporal Deacon St. John. Hey, you got your ears on, man? Hey.
Taylor, what do you need?
Okay, so I finally figured out the damn thing. All right, I got a secure channel and everything. So how's it going, man?
Taylor, I'm kind of busy right now, so...
Yeah. Sorry, man, sorry. hey, so word's out in the camp. The Turks are making their way in, right under the colonel's nose. It's good stuff, too. But do you know anything about that?
I don't do drugs, Taylor. No, I don't know anything about it.
No. I don't either. I saw this guy, you know, one of the new recruits, acting all suspicious. He rides in.
Okay, you were saying?
I saw this guy. You know, one of the new recruits acting all suspicious. He rides in and out of camp all the time, and so I thought I'd follow him, right? Let's see what the hell he's about.
Ah, goddammit. Taylor, listen to me. You just go to Corey, let him handle it. You got that?
Yeah. That's a good call. Yeah. Okay, Mr. St. John, I'll talk to you later, man. Yeah, out.
Jesus Christ, Taylor, what the hell are you doing? More bounties.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The feds were whining babies, suckling at the teat of us taxpayers. But dumb as they were, we can't underestimate them. You gotta know that Chief Muckety Mucks are hiding out there in some bunker, waiting for the freaks to die off. They didn't save the hungry, or their precious constituents. You know the real reason they're in power. They saved the elite, the men and women who played ball. They're sitting underground, probably drinking champagne while they wait. Meanwhile, we're out here dying, suffering. Also, the feds can hit the damn reset button. They didn't account for one thing. We're not as stupid as they thought we were. And once they emerge to reclaim the world when the freaks are gone, we'll be waiting. Oh, yes, we will. And they'll be sorry they ever came out of hiding. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jesus, even all the way down here, I can't get away from goddamn Radio Free Oregon.
This. Squeeze through here. You still got your militia armband? Just gotta go back and turn this in.
He's with us. Open up.
Okay. Hello?
Corporal, what can I get for you? Hey, you looking for something? I'll fix it right up there. All right, then. Oh, Corporal St. John, you stay safe, yeah?
Captain, I found your man, Anderson. You were right. He still had his militia insignia.
He's dead?
Well, let's just say that he had a run-in with a pack of wolves long before I got to him.
That's a fitting end for a murderer and a thief.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Corporal. Dismissed.
Corporal St. John.
Howdy there, Corporal. What's up? So how long were you in the service? I mean, yeah, I missed the swearing in, but I can always tell when someone served. You know what I mean?
4 years, 10th Army, Afghanistan. Like I told the colonel, I hated every goddamn minute of it. How about you?
Yeah. You got the eye for it, too, huh? Me? No, nothing so grandiose like you. National Guard, 8 years. I actually kind of loved it, you know, pushing pencils and Salem and playing soldier on the weekends. But you're the real deal.
We all did our part.
Yeah, we did it that. That is true. Mm-hmm. See you, Corporal. Keep that gun close.
I got the gate.
Hey, Corporal. What can I get you?
Sergeant.
Nope. Okay. Corporal St. John, you stay safe. Got that?
Corporal St. John! We tailored it, Deacon St. John.
Taylor, I hear a bike. Tell me you're not out in the shit tracking down that drug trafficker.
Okay, okay. I won't tell you that. But I am.
Damn it, Taylor, you're gonna get yourself killed.
No, man, no, no. Hey, I followed a bunch of them up the highway.
On 97?
Hey, it was daylight. The weather was clear. I didn't see a single freak. But there is this group of... It was daylight. The weather was clear. I didn't see a single freak. But there is this group of men ended up at the ski lodge. Did you even know there was a ski lodge out here? I didn't know that.
Taylor.
It's a sweet-ass setup, too. If I ever decide to bug out, that is where I'm going. Oh, shit! I gotta run. They're stopping at another camp. Taylor, out.
Taylor.
Taylor, God damn it. Stupid kid's gonna get himself killed.
Deacon St. John, the Captain Corey. St. John Akuri, come back.
St. John, I've just spoken with the Colonel. He's assigned you to the Research Division?
Captain, Research Division, I guess you would call it that. I'm helping Lieutenant Weaver and Lieutenant Whitaker.
Good. They can use all the help you can offer.
I don't know how much help I'm gonna be, and just sort of their errand boy for now. And actually, that's why I radioed in. Lieutenant Whitaker gave me a requisition form that says yeast.
Yeast? Hold a second. We have patrols making supply runs throughout the region. When they come across anything of potential value, they note it down. Yes, here. Yeast and other baking supplies were noted in the kitchen area of the Crater Lake Visitors Center. You know where that is?
Yeah, I could find it.
Good luck, Corporal. Curry out.
Finally. Is it? God damn, that's gotta be close. You murdering assholes can't let any of them get out of here alive.
Thank you.
Another Nero site. Well, wonder if there's anything in that MMU. You like killing drifters, is that it? How do you like it now? There's another one. I got you now, asshole.
Freakers!
Thank you.
How do you like that, huh? Okay, time for the rest of you. Yeah. What do you think now, huh? Somebody shoots back. How do you like that? You can't hide, you son of a bitch.
Something's here.
What's that? I got a use for you.
What the hell?
Yeah, one more to go.
doors off. Figures.
Oh, I think that's it. Roads will be a little safer now. Not much, but a little.
Bunker, yeah. Bet they had a bunker. Just gotta find it. Gotta take a closer look.
Alright, what have we got?
Oh, where the hell am I gonna get a fuse? Out of gas. Of course. Tunnel heading west. I guess Nero didn't want anyone getting to the coast. Okay. This is it. It needs scrap. All right, where? Still got this. Feels, yes.
Here we go. Green lights are good. Green lights are good.
Finally. Jesus.
Open. Locked. Another Nero injector. Good.
Looks like they marked it up good. Hey, what's this?
Crafting. Yes, yes, yes. Good.
Guys, open the damn gate.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Hey, D, we got a question for you.
What the hell's an East Coast city boy doing all the way the hell out here?
Actually, yeah. Served with the guy from Long Island. Accent's kind of hard to miss.
No shit, right? Let me tell you, man. Before shit went down, I used to run this website called YouNeedGunsIGotGuns.com.
Oh, Jesus. Holy shit. That's where I've seen you before. You had a cable show. My old man used to watch it back in the day.
Yeah, your old man had good taste. Goddamn right I did. I used to travel the country hitting up out-of-the-way gun shows, flea markets, shit like that.
I guess this is about as out-of-the-way as it gets.
I guess it isn't that, huh? Hey, Corporal. I'll see you.
Corporal, how are you? Want to turn in some bounties? Nice haul.
That's it.
Okay. Corporal, you take care now.
Corporal. Hey, you're almost on empty. Want me to fill her up? Yep, I got just the tool for that. Okay. Hey, Corporal. See you later.
Hey, Corporal. How's life?
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. It has come to my attention that some of you are out there working with Nero. The very same Nero we saw cut down a group of survivors not too long ago. The same Nero that abandoned us here in this shit 2 years past. Some would call these people fools. But I got a better name for them. Traitors. And I assure you, I don't take treason lightly. But I am a reasonable man. So you get one warning. Listen up. Stop what you're doing. Now. Before we find you. Cause we will. And when we do, you will pay. I'll personally string you up on the biggest tree I find. And while you're breathing your last, we'll quarter you and feed you to the freaks you love. That is a promise. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Visitor sitter. It's gotta be it. No, I just gotta find some yeast.
Kitchen, yeah.
Well, it's gotta be in the kitchen.
Oh, shit. Breakers.
Had to be breakers.
That couldn't be fucking easy, could it?
Okay. Now where the hell is the yeast?
Got it.
Yes. I hope this is enough.
St. John to Lieutenant Whitaker, reporting in.
Deacon, Corporal St. John, yes.
I got the item on your requisition form, the yeast. There wasn't much.
I'm sure that whatever you have is gonna be fine.
So, just curious, why do you need...
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something. I gotta go. I'll talk to you when you bring it in. Whitaker out. Damn it.
Ma'am?
Would you stop doing that, please?
I'm sorry?
I know that things are strange, but I can't help that right now.
Well, I live in a barracks with a dozen militia assholes, and my wife lives in a private tent up on an officer's ridge. Nothing strange about that.
Deacon.
And the only time that I see her is when I'm done running one of her errands. Nothing strange about that either, ma'am.
Please, thank you.
Are you baking something? I mean, if you need an oven, I know where to find one.
No, I'm using it to create viral proteins that they trigger these antibodies. But of course, you were being sarcastic.
Bread, viral proteins, it's all the same to me.
Hey, wait a second. Here. Thank you.
You already said that.
I'm in for stay.
No, set them over there. Thank you. Corporal St. John, this is Dr. Jimenez. St. John?
Hey, Doc. This is Deacon. What can I do for you?
St. John, good. I need you to stop by the infirmary.
Something wrong? You need something?
No. Nothing like that. I want to check on that arm.
My arm? My arm's fine, Doc.
A burn like that? From a wood stove? It's nothing to play around with. You want la infección? You come see me. That's an order.
All right, Doc. All right, fine. Whatever you say. St. John out.
Huh? Okay. Hey, Corporal. You stay out of trouble, you hear me? Hey, Corporal. How's life?
Sarge.
Corporal. Yeah, okay. This needs some work. Hang on. Okay. Got it. Okay. Corporal, see you.
I'm here.
Look, I know we have a lot to talk about.
Ma'am?
This is a private channel. Deke?
Okay.
I want you to know that I meant what I said about you staying and helping.
Nice job.
I know this can't be easy for you, being here like this.
Hey, where else am I gonna go? And if I leave, they're gonna make me get back this really cool hat, so I'm starting to like this hat. I mean, really.
Oh, I bet. Okay, all right, I gotta get back to work. This yeast has already filled up like half a dozen petri dishes.
Okay, save me some of the viral proteins. I got an appetite out here.
I'll do that. Lieutenant Whitaker out.
Yep, we got good old American gasoline. Coming right up. Corporal.
Howdy there,
stay
Corporal.
Safe out there.
What's up?
Sergeant.
Ah, that's Corporal St. John.